Good morning, dear children. Today we are going to study about message writing. What is a message writing and how to write a message? And what are the important points we should keep in mind while writing a message? A message is a form of written communication. It is a form of written communication used when verbal communication is not possible. When verbally we are not able to talk to someone, we write a written message and leave for that person. Clear? When verbally we cannot talk to the person directly, we write the message on a piece of paper and leave for that person. That is called message writing. The purpose of message is to communicate something very important. If it is very urgently we want to talk to someone or we convey any message to someone, we can convey it through the written message. To give instructions for some urgent work. If we have to give instruction to someone about any urgent work, we can give that through the message. To provide an important explanation about something. When we want to give an explanation regarding something which is very important and we don't have to talk verbally with that person, we can leave the message. We can write the message and can pass to the person. Dear children, both notices and messages are important modes of written communication. Notices and messages both are very important mode of written communication. Both are the written communications. However, they are different in terms of form and function. There is a little difference in the message and the notice. What is the difference? Notice is formal communication. In a formal tone we write, and message is informal communication. Notice is structured pattern. It is having a proper pattern, and the message is not having so strict structure. Got it? Now dear children, here on page number 212, the sample is given here. Here the conversation, telephonic conversation between Ranjit's mother and someone asking for him. Here the conversation of the mother and the stranger is given. The stranger who is asking about Ranjit. Okay, so Ranjit is not at home and that person has left some message for Ranjit because he could not talk to Ranjit directly verbally. Isn't it? He could not talk to him directly, so he left the message through Ranjit's mother. Now Ranjit's mother got the message, but she has to go out. Ranjit's mother has to go out, so she leaves the following message for Ranjit. What she does, she got the message from the stranger. Now she herself is going out. It is important for her to go out. So she will write the message for Ranjit, whatever is said by the stranger. Here the sample is given. Structure of the message. First of all, we should see the structure of the message. A message is very short. Like a letter, we cannot write a very long message. Clear? Message should be very short and the necessary things should be mentioned in that. Only the information of immediate importance, the informations which are very immediate at the moment, should be mentioned in the message. And then after that, the name of the person the message is meant for. This message is meant for Ranjit. So Ranjit's name should be mentioned in this. Message should be addressed to Ranjit. Then the name of the person who writes the message. Name of the person who writes the message should be mentioned in the message. And then the date and time also should be mentioned in the message. That is another important thing. Got it? So dear children, you can see here in the sample on page number 213, message also should be written inside the box. Clear? Message should also be written inside the box. And on the top, you should, inside the box, you should write message. The heading you should write, message, in the center of the page in capital letters. Clear? After writing this, to the left hand side of the box, you should mention the day and the date. Suppose you are writing this on 29th September 2020. Clear? After the message, you will write the day and date on which you are writing the message. And then you should mention the time, at what time you are writing the message. Suppose this message you are writing at 10:30 a.m. Clear? That also should be mentioned at the left hand side. Clear? And then you should address the person. Name of the person you should write to whom you are writing the message. Suppose this message is written to Ranjit. Clear? Name of the person. And everywhere you should leave the line. After writing the message, you should leave one line here. Then after writing the day and date, you should leave line. Then after writing the time, you should leave line. And then after writing the person's name, you should leave the line. And then comes the body of the message, the main points. Clear? Body of the message you should mention. After mentioning the body of the message, at last comes the name of the person who is writing the message. Clear? Name of the person should be written who is writing the message. Here you can see the message. Mr. Raju Srivastav from Children's World Books called up. Here, when you write the message, you should leave the message very clearly. And another important thing here, you can see on page number 213 in the box, the tip is given. A message need not to be written in complete sentences. It is not compulsory that write the sentence incomplete. We can drop words such as articles, conjunctions and finite verbs. We can drop in that. Remember that you must not drop words that help in understanding your message. The important words which will help you understand the message should be written. You can drop the articles or the conjunctions or some finite verbs, but the important words which will help you to understand the message should be written in that. Here we'll read the sample of the message given here. Mr. Raju Srivastav from Children's World Books called up 9:50 a.m. Your entry in their cartoon strip competition has been selected as the best entry. Mr. Srinivas needs to talk to you about the prize distribution function. Call him up immediately. Mr. Srinivas' number is given here. Congratulations, son. Okay, so this is the body of the message, the important points about what the person has called up is mentioned very clearly in the message. Clear? So all the important points should be mentioned in the message, because verbally we are unable to communicate with the person. So in written form, in written mode, we are writing the message. So that should be mentioned. Okay? So if you will read this sample message, it will be very helpful for you to understand the format, the structure. You just remember, it should be written inside the box. Then on the top, you should write message that should be in the center of the page and in capital letters. After that, to the left hand side, you should, after message, you should leave one line. Then you should write the day and the date. After writing the day and date, leave one line again and then write the time, at what time you are writing the message. Again, after the time, you have to leave the line and then you will address the person whom you are writing the message. Clear? After addressing the person, after writing the salutation, you will leave one line and then you will write the body of the message. The important message should be mentioned in the body of the message. And again, you will be leaving one line after body of the message. And then at last, you will write the name of the person who writes the message. Dear children, here the questions are given. To write the messages, I'll give you the instructions later on, which questions you have to do by yourself. So I hope you understood what is a message writing and how to write a message. Try to solve this exercise. It's given on page number 213. You can see, write down message with the help of the following hints and context. Here, the hints are given. Read the question number 1 carefully and try to write the message. Thank you.